She adored me. I can't say I blame her. She was so sweet and kind.
She was. She still is. Adored by her family, her children, and her grandchildren. You missed out on it all, Scrooge. Why?
I loved her, Isabel.
Did you?
Yes, I truly loved her.
And why did you let her go?
I didn't.
Really?
She left me.
Yes? We talked with parents for quite some time, but there's still no plan of a wedding.
There'll be a wedding when I have enough money to support such an enterprise. Now I have work to do.
When will that ever be, Ebenezer? How much is enough? I want to marry you, not your cash box.
I will decide when I will know. Now I have work to do.
No, you found another love to replace me. She is much more desirable than I.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
This lady here.
How should I ever understand this world? There is nothing on which it is such high as poverty, and nothing on which on such severity as the pursuit of wealth.
It's true. It was true then, and it's true now.
One by one, all your noble dreams I have seen fall away, until all that is left is the desire for gain.
I'm not changed towards you.
In words, no, but in changed nature, yes. And everything that made your love of value to me. If you met me today.
I would. I do.
Shh.
I still do.
Isabel, I find it impossible to talk to you about personal affairs during business hours. Now, please.
You see, if you weigh me by gain, I weigh very little. Therefore, I am love enough for you. I release you with a full heart for the love of him.
It's a mistake. Don't go. Don't let her go.
You may have pain in this, but it will pass. And you will dismiss the recollection of it gladly, this unprofitable dream, in which it happened while at your home.
Say something, you fool! Say something!
I hope you enjoy it like you've chosen.
Isabel!